Hey everyone, I just juggled for 1 hour straight and you are going to see that in the video. There was a ton of work that went into this. I failed so many times. I'm gonna have a little quick montage of the fails right here.
I started the 30 minute juggling. So, see how it goes. What were you saying? Wait, you have an iPad that just disappeared? They did actually do that, and it's kind of lame. They're trying to make like reparations for it. If you have like an iPhone 6 or below, they purposefully slowed down their stuff, and they give you like $25 in reparations for that. Like, for it's so lame. $25 is nothing. You spend like a Yeah, so that, you know, they're the richest company in the world. They're even more rich than Amazon. I think they have like over $1 trillion net. $2 trillion, oh yeah. Like, that's a lot of money. Yeah, so that's why the owner of Apple isn't the richest guy in the world. He has like less shares, less percentage of shares than I'd say Jeff Bezos has of Amazon. He's like, oh, did he just hit 200 billion? I don't know. That is so much money. Did I tell you about this? That Jeff Bezos is rich enough to buy the moon? Did I tell you this? So basically, you can officially buy an acre of land on the moon for $20. 1 acre is $20. And that land, that 1 acre is yours. Like, it would technically be trespassing if somebody went onto your 1 acre of, if an astronaut went onto your 1 acre of land on the moon. So anyways, there's like 9.3 billion acres of land on the moon, which means for $180 million, roughly, Jeff Bezos could buy the moon. Like, you gotta admit, that would be kind of awesome. So nobody officially, like, I don't know, it'd be kind of funny. It's things like that, like, just wasted money, but it gets you some sort of title deed that's kind of funny. There's another one, I think it's in Sweden, I'm not sure, but if you own any land, and we're gonna say Sweden, it might not be, but there's some place that if you own any land, you are rightfully a lord or lady of that land. So, and for like $50, you can buy a square foot of land in that country, and then on your like actual birth certificate and passport and all that stuff, you can put the word lord or lady on it. So you can literally, like, people will call you like Lord Walker. It's kind of funny or something. Not gonna lie, it's probably worth $50 to get that kind of respect that you would get from a title like that. But imagine if you're like my age, 16, you're like a lord. It's like, it'd be kind of weird. How big is it? Oh, so it's like 200 or 128 gigabytes or something. Oh, a terabyte. Dang, that's a lot. I know, they just keep coming up with better and better technology for storing stuff. My dad, he works at CBS as an editor, and he needs a lot of storage. So he, for like, I think $200 or $300, bought this absolutely tiny storage hard drive. It's like the size of a small book, and it holds 10 terabytes. Yeah, it's like 6 inches long, maybe an inch and a half wide, and a couple inches tall. Like, it's so small. But technology just gets better and better. Something like that, or even your terabyte one 10 years ago, would have easily been over $1,000. And the funny thing is, he's filled that thing up, all 10 terabytes. I'm thinking about buying a hard drive. So, my question is, like, is it just added storage onto your computer? Like, can you access it pretty quickly if it's plugged in, like, your extra files and stuff? Yeah, So another question I have is, if you were to like download stuff, could you automatically have it go into there, like your downloads? Yeah, probably. I know, because my computer, it's a PC. It has like a terabyte of storage, but I've used like 300 gigabytes. I'm just thinking once I run out, I might get a big hard drive for it or something. Do you have a PC or a laptop? Do you have a PC or laptop? Oh, yeah. Can you like easily transfer videos and stuff from your iPad or phone to that hard drive, which then can get to your computer? Like a special adapter or something, like that plugs into a phone and then has a USB on the other side. Machine gotten. Can't you check that like in YouTube Studio? It's gotten a few watch hours. You know what I also bet? I bet your smaller Infinite Machine, the 4 minute one or whatever, I bet you that has more watch time than the long one. Dang. Yeah. Now, what about the short one? And then also, what sort of comments are you getting on the 1 hour? I knew it! I knew it would have more. You could put it on like your reverse Plaxen Productions channel. I don't know how you say it. And then just see if that goes up to 10.4 if you play it for once through. Hey, do you know what my timer is at? Oh no. Does it say I'm paused still? All right, there's no way for me to unpause it or call you back, so I'll just have my sister do it or something. Hey, Scarlett! Could you check what my timer is at? I have no way of telling. This is something. It's gotta be a... Uh-oh. Wait, is that you calling me? Are you calling me, Scarlett? Okay. Somebody's calling me. I would guess I'm at around 12 or 13 minutes. So I would imagine at least another 15 before I have any chance at a half an hour. Yeah, so when my sister comes in and checks, we can do the math. Oh, hey, so daylight savings happened. I am now on your time that what it was before it changed. What, did you also go forward an hour? Yeah, so I guess it doesn't. Arizona, I know for one. Huh. Random stuff. It's like you find a cursed album or something with like 200 videos that you haven't uploaded that you didn't even know you made. It's like you never know what to do with that many or with that many videos. I'm not sure you've uploaded 200 videos since you started YouTube. Yeah. Or it's like, what if you found videos that your future self posted? So it's like, how weird that would be. You find like an album that, and it has like videos that you have not made yet. This time in the Twilight Zone. I'm just kidding. All right, here she comes. Hey.
Hi.
All right, so what am I at?
Where do I check?
It's on the computer.
17 minutes.
17 minutes. All right, so Nick, I'm at 17. So what's the time? Thank you, Scarlett. 5:34. All right, so at about 5:51, I will have 30 minutes. Thank you, Scarlett. Oh wait, 5:47, that's right. My math was so off there. So when I've been playing on my Minecraft world, I've been getting videos and stuff. Clips and whatever of me building, and I have this plan that in probably about a year's time, I'm gonna make a world of, or a video of 10,000 days on my Minecraft world. And the thing is, I don't know where I'm gonna upload that once I make that. I don't know if I wanna do it on OneBuck, because that, I've never done gaming stuff, and I do not want to turn that channel into a gaming channel. But then again, it's only going to be one video. Like, I'm not going to make any more. Yeah. I know, but that's still real life. I've also done, like, You Want to Go. Maybe I can. Oh, that's also a year or so away, so I'll figure it out when I get there. That Bat 19 video was so fun. There was some insane video I saw. Some billionaire basically was challenged to go into a town where nobody knows him. He's absolutely not known. He cannot enter that town with any money. There's no calling outside sources, nothing of it. Basically, he's a nobody. And he has 90 days to try to make a million-dollar business, or else a certain punishment happens. I don't know what it was. But this billionaire was so confident, he said he would not need 90 days. And he also said to make it a $10 million business, or else he would like buy people a bunch of cars and stuff. And it was some TV show, and like, that's insane. He was so confident that in less than 90 days, he can make $10 million from nothing. It just shows that like, I'm only 90 days away from being a multimillionaire, if done correctly. I think he did. I don't know. It was some after video of the show. It was some TikTok video I saw. It was like an interview after he did the 90 days thing. He was basically like, he was so confident. Like, it was insane. Is it plugged in? Like, do you know it's charged? It may... What do you need on there? Yeah, potentially, like, if that thing is just trash, you could maybe take the chip or storage unit, whatever it is, figure out how to take that out of there. It'd be complicated. I don't know how you would do it, but you can maybe use that and then plug it into your hard drive. All right, so I'm getting kind of curious now. I have to go to 5:47. What time is it now? Okay, so that means I've been going for 22 minutes. 23:18 is my record. My legs are starting to, like, there's a lot of blood pressure in them from standing. I'm gonna bend my knees a little bit. Maybe you had nothing to do. Boy, that was before COVID. Would have been nice to spend that time outside with friends. I'm just kidding. I might have beaten you there. I started my channel a long time ago, but a lot of those original videos I deleted, like the Agario videos. he sold it to some guy in Europe, and then they sold it, and you're gonna have to track all those guys down to get this one file of your video. That sucks. I know, I've been having the same trouble kind of with encoding all these videos from my pyramid project. There's 40 hours of footage and we have to encode it all, and it's turning out to be like 1.6 terabytes of footage. And it's crazy too, because like we've only done like 3 out of 120 videos. Because they're so long. Some of them are short, but the majority of them are long. There's one that's 2.5 hours of just video. Like, that was an entire day working. All right, I have to ask again. I'm getting impatient. What's the time? All right. Oh, I'm gonna keep going as long as I can. I'm gonna try to go for an hour. If I can only do 30 minutes, then that's fine. The challenge, I've changed it to 30 minutes, so anything over is bonus. All right, yeah, tell me when it's like 5:48, if you could. Thank you for helping. I'll put a little thing that says, thanks to Nick or Plaxen Productions for keeping track of time in the description. I wonder if anybody is gonna watch this far through into the video. If they do, how about this? Let's say comment birthday party. Anybody who comments birthday party into the description watched this far through. It's so random too, so like, they would never know. I have to read Macbeth, Shakespeare. It is so, like, it is boring. It's so hard to read Shakespeare. And I'm reading the No Fear Shakespeare version, which is even easier. Like, it's translated into modern day English. And it's hard to read still. I'm like 30 pages into the 72 pages that it is or something. My mom says I should be reading the actual old English one, the one that he wrote it in, but I basically had the counter argument that it's about 1 in every 1,000 lines of Shakespeare that something meaningful, like a quote, is actually reused. It's like for the other 999 lines, I'm just painting my brain to try to understand this insane language. It's worse than Spanish. It's like, because you kind of recognize it, but you can't read it. Spanish, on the other hand, I'm learning it. I know I can't read it, but I know it's doable. You know, on the subject of languages, there was a thought I had never really thought of. I have a friend who speaks sign language, or speaks it, can signal it, and he said American Sign Language. And then that gave me the thought, there's Spanish Sign Language and French and German Sign Language. Like, there's more than just English and sign languages. They're communicating the English language in signs. So it's like, you have to know Spanish and sign language to be able to do Spanish sign language. Like, it's just kind of interesting. All right, what's the time? I gotta be getting, all right. I think I've done it. So I'm gonna just yeah. So if I can go to 502, 517, about 518, that will be an hour. I won't go much longer than that. My previous best was 23 minutes and 18 seconds. All right, I can relax now because I've probably passed 30 minutes. If I make it to 549, then I've definitely done it. This is turning into a YouTube video. It doesn't matter where I mess up. So, I finally have like been getting motivated to start running again. And I had a really fast run yesterday night. I went 1.9 miles in, I think, 7 minutes and 29 seconds or something. Which is pretty bad, but that's like maybe a little slower than a 7 minute mile. The thing was, at the beginning of that 7 minutes, right as I was starting, I was going up a huge hill and I was doing it at like a 9 minute mile, and that was probably 2 minutes of it. So I ran like the rest of it really fast. I ran the rest of that at like, I don't know, 6 minute mile, I think. So I was pretty proud of myself. Should I have Scarlett check it out again? I could also have her call you back. So you could actually see me. It's so weird that it's paused. I don't think I will. I'll just kind of keep track of the math. Oh no, another one. Yeah, all right. Yeah, it's like you find one from when you're like 7 years old. It's like, I could upload it, but I don't think I will.
Yeah.
Stick or something.
A clear phone.
That's actually hilarious. I never would have thought a clear fork. Like, I think the best thing that you can do to make it look like it didn't fail is rebuild like 5 seconds before it. Use like air compressor to blow over the domino that it was gonna do, and then kind of like do a camera cut and show the before it, so it looks like it's showing the same thing but from a different angle, and you can tell that it didn't fail because it showed the same thing twice or something. Like, yeah, or something. Yeah, you know, I used to, at least you did thumbnails. Hey, what's my timer at? It's on the computer.
36 minutes.
Nice. All right, 24 more minutes. Thank you. All right, so I'm at, I think you heard my dad. He said 36 minutes. I wonder, I kind of want to say something like beginner juggler juggles for an hour or something. I don't know. What should I name this? Or like, I juggle for an hour as a beginner? Or first time juggling for 1 hour straight. Assuming I'd make it another 24 minutes. All right. Yeah. Juggling for 10 hours straight. It's like, oh. It's kind of freaky to think that I've been standing here for basically 40 minutes just doing this. This is also my first attempt of today. I think, yeah, possibly I'll probably start editing it on FaceTime today, depending on how long you can stay on FaceTime. I'm gonna just like get a small compilation. I'm gonna make some sort of video saying, I learned to juggle, I wanna do it for an hour, and then I think I'm gonna say, here are all the fails, this took a lot of work, so make sure to like it. It'll be like, it's sad, there were like several 10 minute plus fails. Maybe I should make a short video and then the full upload. That might be how I do it, actually. Oh. The other. Yeah. So the other one you haven't uploaded or something? Yeah. All right, at 6:02 your time. What time is it now? Alright, so at 6:02, that's 45 minutes, roughly. Around 70 minutes if I can make it there, because that's gonna be 10,000 catches. It's gonna be somewhere over 10,000 because I get it in about 43 seconds. I get 100 catches, and multiplying that 1,000 catches is like 6 minutes and 40 seconds. So I'll just round up to about 7 minutes, and then 10 times that is 70 minutes. I'm gonna just. What sounds better? I juggled for an hour, or I got 10,000 catches with juggling? Honest. Yeah, I kind of think so. So I might say I juggled for over an hour if I can make it to 70 minutes. And then I kind of think I could also turn it into two videos. A short edited one and then a full video. Hey, how long did it take to upload your hour-long video? Dang, that's still a very long time. I might try it overnight on my computer or from my phone because I don't really want to upload it to my computer. I don't know, it's kind of cool to have an archive of all your videos. Hey Scarlett, could you check when I'm at again? And then, also I'll have her FaceTime you back.
You're at 45.
Alright, could you go on my iPad and FaceTime Nick back?
Mm-hmm.
So, Nick is on the phone right now. Hey Nick, she's gonna hang up and then.
Okay. Walker.
What?
You have so many emails.
It doesn't matter. Just please, yeah. All right, and then make sure that he can see the screen. Hey. All right. Hey, can you see me now? Can you see the screen? Thanks, Scarlett. Great. Yeah, that was Scarlett. She FaceTimed you back. So I've over doubled my PB, 23 minutes and 18 seconds. So. As long as it's 46 minutes and 36 seconds, and I've doubled it. It's definitely been 16 seconds since you checked, so. Question is, can I triple it and make it to 70 minutes and call it a day? Oh boy, my forehead's getting itchy. I'm not really getting tired, I'm just sweating a lot. Here you're doing some writing. Yeah. Oh, are you like crossing them off or something? Like. My eyes are tired. I'm gonna be like hypnotized when I stop. All right. I've probably passed your longest time juggling. So I think you said you went for like 46 minutes or something. A while back. I couldn't see you, I mean, randomly just juggling for hours. I couldn't see myself doing it if it wasn't a challenge. Yeah. Wasted an hour of my day doing this. I'm not gonna want to stop once I hit 70 minutes, but I probably should. I'm sorry, I'm not really talking too much anymore. Oh, did you end up finishing that one video with the worms? Nice. Have you edited it yet? Yeah. And then that one's at the back of all the videos to be uploaded, right? I suppose. Oh, I'm really blinking a lot. My eyes are getting dry. And there is like a constant downpour of water on my back. It's kind of gross, but it's true. More videos? Wait. Oh, to your hard drive? Yeah. Okay. I was gonna say. Yeah. Nice. All right, so 17 more minutes. All right, maybe if I can keep going after 70 minutes, I'm gonna go for 100 minutes. That would be the longest I would go. But that's still so far away. Maybe I would go to 2 hours. I should stop. I'm not even at 1 hour yet. I gotta plan for when I get there, or plan when I get there. You there? Hey, Nick? Oh no.
Hey, Mom. Come in here. You gonna wanna see what I'm at. It's kind of interesting. Take a look at my computer.
Oh.
What is it at?
56:14.
All right, 3 minutes and 45 seconds.
Amazing.
I was thinking I might go for 70 minutes, because that's around 10,000 catches, and if I can do that, I might try to bump it up to 100 minutes.
Jeez.
Just to see what I can do. Could you check if my phone is still recording?
Sure. Yes.
Yes.
The red button is on.
Nick's phone died.
I can't see the counter, but it's red, so I guess that means it's still recording.
Yeah. So yeah, Nick's phone died. We were calling until about 2 minutes ago. Do you want to stay in here and watch me cross an hour?
Yeah.
I am sweating so hard.
I would turn the fan on for you, but I probably don't want that. Distraction.
It's probably fine. The one on the wall.
I'm going to wait until you hit 60 and I'll turn it on.
All right. The crazy thing is, my goal for this, I bumped it down to 30 minutes because I felt like an hour was too hard.
And then you just kept going?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
What's it at now?
It is at 58.
All right, 2 minutes. I'm not tired at all. It's just my legs. They have so much blood pressure and I'm trying to like bend them every once in a while. At 59 yet?
Almost.
All right.
There you go.
All right, 1 minute. You want to give me a countdown?
Yeah, you're at 41. 43, 44, 48.
Thank you, by the way. Oh, that's Nick. He's calling me on my iPad.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's an hour.
Nice. Hey, could you pick up my iPad? Nick is calling me on it. Thank you for all the help.
Oh.
Oh, you can try calling back. Nice. Nice. Hey. So, my mom just watched the timer cross over 1 hour. And I'm still going. So I have I think your phone died.
Thank you. Sorry, Nick. I'm like talking to my family too. It's kind of hard to hear. So, what's that they were saying? Oh, my shoulders.